Amy, how are the homeless coping with these changes?
Good evening to you, Shelley. You know, some are fighting back, like those three homeless men that we learned about who are suing the state with the help of the ACLU for their right to camp on public lands. Others we found today are simply ignoring that new ordinance, working the streetlights right here with signs they've been holding for months.
Oh, how long you been holding that sign?
I've been holding this since September.
He wouldn't give us his name. He's 51 years old, used to play in a rock band, and left his job at a fast food restaurant last fall.
So how much would a sign like this get for you on a given day? What's a good day?
A good day?
Yeah.
$12.
$12?
He says he likes the freedom. His address is, quote, wherever.
No, you're not supposed to be out here now doing this.
Yeah, I don't care. I did time for prison.
While we're talking, this transaction that some would call kindness, but that city leaders now say is a violation that carries fines up to $500, but only for the sign holder, not the motorist.
How long you been doing this, sir?
Not that long, actually.
No?
A couple months, actually.
Are people nice to you?
Yes, they are, actually.
The new ordinance is carefully worded and does not include the term panhandling. It also does not prohibit standing out here and holding a sign.
Technically, somebody could still have a sign asking for help, which is the free speech aspect that the ordinance was concerned about. But if they engage and a citizen and take something or receive something or give something to the motorist, the behavior then becomes against the ordinance, and that would be enforceable.
So it remains to be seen just how aggressively the city of Concord will enforce this new ordinance. We did notice two people working two different intersections who were never approached by police this evening. And we did note two marked police cruisers here on Fort Eddy Road in this retail area. We're live in Concord tonight. Amy Covino, WMU.